comes with a book. I love the packaging on it. Also, guys, welcome to my new background. I'm in my basement right now, and I put this old piece of fabric up, and I haven't steamed it or anything, but I'm planning on doing so. So excuse the look of it. I love the art on tarot cards. Let's see what these look like. And we'll shuffle them. While I'm shuffling them, you can think of a question that you want to consult the oracle about. I have done tarot readings before, but not so in depth. I'm not quite sure what everything means. So this is a good book to give you a guide. See the history and the origin of the tarot. Reading the tarot. Before you begin to do a reading, you need to clear your mind of all thoughts. Shuffle the deck and then take the cards from the top of the deck, unless otherwise instructed, and place them on the table. Working from left to right, the tarot cards all have meanings, and the meanings need to be considered in relation to where they fall in a spread. The position in which a card falls helps to clarify the message of the tarot. You need to become familiar with the images and take time to practice. Later, when you become more experienced, you will be able to use your own intuitive abilities to enhance your reading. I've got to get a crystal ball. So this book also gives you a guide of different kinds of tarot spreads that you can do. So it has the Celtic cross spread, which looks like this. It's the Celtic cross spread. The Mark and Amanda spread, I've never heard of that. That's what that looks like. These are all the cards, I suppose. The Major Arcana. Kind of breaking everything up for you. Here's an extended version of the Celtic cross spread. This is a sample reading. Mary's daily inspirational reading. I think you just do 9, it looks like. And then you read it horizontal, vertical, diagonal. Oh, here, this is telling you how to read the daily inspiration spread. That's one we might do if you want to do one. It tells you about the author on the back. Amanda Hall. So I think we might do the daily inspiration spread. And what we'll do is I'll lay them out and we will interpret it as the instructions say. I'm gonna go ahead and get started and light that candle. Okay, so we shuffled the cards earlier, and the instructions here tell me to take 9 cards from the top of the deck, so that's what we're gonna do. So you can see the 9 cards spread out on the table here, and it tells me to read the first row from left to right. So we're gonna start up here. These are your 3 cards up at the top. The High Priestess, it's the highest card in the tarot deck, very powerful, good or bad. Secrets to be revealed. The Chariot. Movement of residence, journey, victory over a situation or problem, and balancing the opposite polarities. The Six of Swords. Boat or over water travel, turning boat out of troubled waters into calmer waters. Those all seem pretty positive. That's great, that's what we want. Okay, let's see the next. It's number 4. Read the second row from left to right. Five of Swords. Losses. All is not lost as you still have three swords remaining, giving you the upper hand. So it's a little bit of something, but you'll still pull through. Four of Swords. Sickness, bed illness, need to take time out. Rest and relaxation is needed here. Maybe if you've been a little bit stressed, you need to take some time for yourself. Four of Wands. Happy home. Possible country setting. So I noticed that the next number five is to read the third row from left to right. The Three of Wands. Travel overland, surveying your kingdom. Two of Wands. A short journey. Movement to or near water. That's interesting. You have two at the bottom, like similar, and one at the top. And the last one, Ace of Wands. New beginnings, birth, new ideas, creation. It says to read each row vertically and read in a diagonal line from top left to bottom right. Then read in a diagonal line from top right to bottom left. So we'll interpret that in a minute. But it says, the most important card is five. In the middle of the spread, this becomes the now card. So, that looks like this one. This one is maybe what you're going through now. Needing to take some R&R, some you time, some self-love. So, make sure to do that. That's super, super important. I'm gonna skip number six because we already see vertically things here. This is to read each row vertically. 1, 4, and 7. 2, 5, and 8. And 3, 6, and 9. So like that. So that'd be this one, this one, that one, and so on and so forth. But what's interesting is I'm gonna read in a diagonal line from top left to bottom right. So 1, 5, and 9. So starting with 1, the High Priestess, very powerful, secrets to be revealed. Number 5, the now card, which we talked about before, the rest and relaxation. And the Ace of Wands, new beginnings, birth, new ideas, creation. So what I interpret from that is maybe something is going on. You're a powerful person at work. Something might happen and you're stressed out and you need some rest and relaxation. And then at the end, the outcome would be new beginnings, birth, new ideas, creation. So that seems like it makes sense and it would work out. It's telling me to read in a diagonal line from top right to bottom left, 3, 5, and 7. So the Six of Swords, boat or over water travel, turning boat out of troubled waters into calmer waters. Again, with number 5 in the middle. Let's see, number 5. The rest and relaxation. And the outcome, 3 of Wands. Travel overland, surveying your kingdom. So, again, with the turning boat out of troubled waters into calmer waters, that can be stressful in itself, whatever it may be. Work situation, a relationship situation. Oh, I can't talk today, guys. This always happens. The rest and relaxation always going with that. That's a super important one. And then the outcome, the Three of Wands, traveling overland, surveying your kingdom. So you will be rewarded for your efforts. So guys, I hope you enjoyed that. I've never done that kind of thing before. I've just kind of done it for myself, looking at the cards. Oh boy, I just picked out this one. But there's a way to interpret that it's, you can, there's always a positive outcome in my eyes when I read tarot. So you might get a bad card once in a while, but it could just be something that you have to go through in life, whether it be frustration, or an issue at work, or a financial situation, or you're moving, or you just feel like everything in your life is chaotic. But there seems to be a pattern here where we see you at a starting point, and it's either, you know, overcoming something or going through something that's stressful. But taking some rest and relaxation for yourself, and then you will be rewarded with, you know, new beginnings, birth, new ideas, creation, or you travel, you might get a vacation, things like that. So guys, there's always something positive to see when you're reading tarot. And that was quite interesting how it worked out when we read the spread. I've never done this spread before, but I think that was really interesting. And thank you for watching. If you liked it, let me know. I thought it was kind of fun. If you want me to do more videos like this in the future, let me know. I still look at all your requests and everything.